And welcome back, everyone, for week 9 of the 2019 NFL season. I guess we're officially into the second half of the season. We've got teams that are going to try to distance themselves away from the pack, and other teams that have to win now or they could be in trouble. Also, we're going to talk about some quarterbacks who are on the hot seat. That's coming up. But first, we'll go to Billy B with his college picks. And I'm back with Billy B's picks. I'm having all kinds of technical difficulties, and I can't upload Billy's segment of the video, but he has been kind enough to give me his picks. We'll start off with his college picks. He went 2-2 last week. He's going to take Virginia Tech over Notre Dame, plus 17. Houston's at Central Florida. He's going to take Houston, plus 23.5. Another underdog, UNLV, plus 9.5 there at Colorado State. One more. Boston College is at my Syracuse Orange. Boston College are 2.5-point dogs. He's going to take them. And he's got a bonus pick for us. Akron's at Bowling Green. He's going to take Bowling Green minus 6. Good luck. The first game we're going to look at has the Houston Texans taking on the Jacksonville Jaguars. The Jaguars are 1.5-point favorites. Not at home. This game is actually being played in London, where the Jaguars seem to play every year. It's like a home away from home for Jacksonville. I don't think Houston's ever played outside of the States, maybe once in Mexico. These two teams played earlier, week 2. I think it was Gardner Minshew's first start as the quarterback for Jacksonville. It was a close game. They lost 13-12. I don't know if Houston can sweep this divisional foe. The secondary is really banged up, and of course, J.J. Watt is gone for the year. I think the wrong team is actually favored here. I like Jacksonville to win this game outright, and you get the 1.5. So let's take the Jacksonville Jaguars plus 1.5. The second game we're going to look at has the Chicago Bears going to Philadelphia, where the Eagles are 5-point favorites at home. This could be a make it or break it game for Mitchell Trubisky, the quarterback for Chicago, who's obviously had lots of struggles. Especially at home, though. You know, Chicago's actually 2-0 away. Their only loss, not in Chicago, was the game in London against the, I think it was the Raiders. And you know what? This might be actually a better spot for Trubisky. He's not going to have the crowds booing him. And that defense is still killer for Chicago. You never know. They could win this game. Chicago, I'm not ready. I cheer for the Vikings. I know the division, the NFC North, very well. And I'm not ready to write off the Bears just yet, especially with that defense. Chicago could win this game. Whether or not they do, I don't know. But that's too many points. Let's take those points. Let's take the Chicago Bears plus 5. The third game we're going to look at has the Detroit Lions going to Oakland, where the Raiders are 2.5-point favorites. Finally at home. I mean, these guys have been on the road forever. I don't know how much is left in the tank for Oakland after 6 weeks away from home. This is the kind of game that Detroit always seems to do well in. You know, their record, I think, is 3-3-1. They should be a lot better than that. Of course, they tied that first week, but they shouldn't have tied. Off the top of my head, I think they've lost to some really tough games. Remember that Kansas City game where they fumbled at the one as they were about to score, and Kansas City ran it 99 yards back for a touchdown? That's how they lost that game. I think they were robbed by the officials in the Green Bay game. Their only other game that they lost was against a good team, against my Vikings. I can't blame them for that. I think the Detroit Lions are actually going to win this game, and you know what? You get some points, too. So let's take those points. Let's take the Detroit Lions plus 2.5. And the fourth game we're going to look at has the Tampa Bay Buccaneers going to Seattle, where the Seahawks are 6-point favorites at home. Seattle has to be careful. You know, last week they ran up the score against Atlanta, and then they fell asleep. Atlanta with a backdoor cover. As a matter of fact, at home, Seattle hasn't played that well. I think they beat the Bengals by 1 point in week 1. I think they've lost 2 other games at home. The Ravens, somebody else comes to mind. It seems like they fall asleep at home, and the Seahawks have that big game against San Francisco next week, which could determine the division. Might be peeking ahead. Tampa Bay, well, Jameis Winston, this could be it for him. You saw Mariota in Tennessee get benched. Maybe Mariota, Winston rather, gets benched if he doesn't play well. He's just been a turnover machine. If he just limits that, the Bucs have a chance. And they, I like the Buccaneers' run defense. I believe they're number one in the NFL. They can stop Seattle from running the ball, force the the Seahawks to pass a lot. They can hang in with this game. Not saying they're going to win, but this is a game that they can keep close. So you know what? Let's take the points. Let's take the Tampa Bay Buccaneers plus six. And for Billy's NFL picks, we both agree on the Indianapolis-Jacksonville game. He's going to take Jacksonville plus 1.5. He likes Washington plus 9.5. They're at Buffalo. The New England Patriots are at Baltimore. The Ravens are 3.5-point dogs. He likes the Ravens in this game. And the final game, unless it's canceled due to lack of interest, he likes the Miami Dolphins plus 3. They're hosting the New York Jets. Good luck. And congratulations to Ren Artisan. Ren, you are the winner of the New York Giants beanie. Well done, Ren. For this week, you know what we're going to do? I bet against the Seattle Seahawks. So let's have a Seattle Seahawks beanie. All you have to do to win this is in the description below, put hashtag, let's take the man's money. Hashtag LTTMM, and you get a chance to win. Good luck. And here's my Let's Take the Man's Money parlay play and the six-game, six-point teaser. We came close again. We got 5 out of 6 on that one. We're going to get it this week. I know it. Here are the plays. For the parlay play, we'll take the Jacksonville Jaguars plus 1.5, Chicago Bears plus 5, Detroit Lions plus 2.5, the Tampa Bay Buccaneers plus 6, and because we're greedy, we'll throw the New York Jets on the money line. They're playing Miami. Can Miami win a game? I don't think so. And we'll throw in New England on the money line. They're playing Baltimore. Let's see if we can jinx New England for their first loss. A $25 bet will get us $829.64. And for the teaser play, we'll tease Jacksonville Jaguars to plus 7.5, Chicago Bears plus 11, Detroit plus 8.5, Tampa Bay Bucks plus 12, New York Jets plus 3, and let's pick the Buffalo Bills and tease them to plus 3. I think they're playing Washington, another team that's struggling. A $25 bet will get us $175. Good luck. All right, and those are our picks for this week. Good luck to you. Make sure you leave us a comment section below. Don't forget to enter our contest and give us a thumbs up as well. And you know what? If you have anything that you'd like to see on the show, something new, you know, we do a teaser, we do a parlay, we do our picks, we do college. If there's something that you think you'd like us to add to the show, let us know in the comment section below. Okay. For my good friend, Billy B. I-M-G-O, let's take the man's money.